But how we respond to disability should be within control. I aim at education and rehabilitation within control. Like my name has been said, I was supported at school by Comfort, a main for female education, and I became the founding member of CAMA, the Comfort Alumni Network with a disability. It was a real life-changing opportunity for me. I acquired disability at the age of 9 months. It so happened that from the rural area that I come from, there are a lot of problems. So my mother had to leave me in a hut where we scared baboons in the fields with my sister, who was more still young. Only to come back from the fields and find that hut started down by fire, and I was inside. I got burns from the head. As I speak right now, there's a cushion on my head that doesn't have hair. The hands and the leg. But growing up with a disability did not stop me from being who I am today. Though I was coming from a tough circumstance, coming from a poverty-stricken family was my greatest limitation. This is when Comfort, coming for female education, that focuses on the support and education of children from less privileged rural communities, came to my rescue. I went on to my secondary school, and this is me now. I dreamt of becoming a physiotherapist one day, as the department had helped me so much to achieve my physical independence through their children therapy. And today, I can say I am a proud rehabilitation technician by profession. I am a social scientist promoting and changing the lives of children with disability in various communities, not just my community only. I just learned that a supportive family and community plays a vital role in the lives of children with disabilities. Once they do not face discrimination, they can achieve their fullest potential. I've been given a chance, and this is me now. And while disability should not be an obstacle, my desire for every child with disability is access. Once given the opportunity, access to health, to education, definitely those children can do the best, can be the best that they want to be in life. Rather than stigma. You know, at one point, I felt like I should I could drop out of school because, you know, the other children, because probably maybe they won't be that support. They would give me names at school, you know, like, I remember this other guy given me a name. You know, they call me a Kanyamatukaroswa in Shona. Like, you said it. But you know, that actually gave me the will to go on, as I had a point to prove. Today, here I am. I'm very proud. And being successful, definitely means you will be able to fight for the rights of children with disability who are in similar circumstances as I was. Thank you. For these and
other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.